同学们好，今天我们来学习第27课 Lesson 27 Mrs. Smith's Living Room。 在上一课当中，我们看到了史密斯太太家的厨房，那么今天呢，我们要看到的是他们家的客厅 Living Room。 在看的时候，还是请大家注意这个房间里面都有一些什么东西，他们的位置在哪儿。 What's in the room and where are they? 好，下面我们就一起来看课文，请回答这样一个具体的问题。Where are the books? 书在哪儿?
Mrs. Smith's living room is large. There is a television in the room. The television is near the window. There are some magazines on the television. There is a table in the room.There are some newspapers on the table. There are some armchairs in the room. The armchairs are near the table. There is a stereo in the room. The stereo is near the door. There are some books on the stereo.There are some pictures in the room. The pictures are on the wall.
史密斯太太的客厅有很多东西。电视 ,a television, 立体声音响 ,a stereo, 桌子 ,a table, 还有一些扶手椅 ,and some armchairs. 那么书到底在哪儿呢 ?Where are the books? The books are on the stereo, 书在立体声音响上。好，一起来看本课中的关键词和词组，请跟我读。Living room, room 房间，它可以和很多词一起来构成复合词，比如说 meeting room 会议室 ，dining room 饭厅 ，near window armchair， 我们可以把这个词分成两半 ，arm 胳膊 ，chair 椅子。这样就好记一些。Door, picture, wall. 好，一起来看本课中的主要语言点。Mrs. Smith's living room is large. 史密斯太太的客厅很大。这一句话是总领全文的。我们来看看客厅里都有些什么东西。There is a television in the room. 房间里面有一台电视。The television is near the window. 电视靠近窗户。There are some magazines on the television. 电视的上面有一些杂志。Television, 电视，在口语中可以简略地说成 TV. Near, 在什么什么的旁边，我们还可以用这样一个介词词组 close to.本课当中出现的 there are 可以连读成 there are some magazines 一些杂志 some 和可数名词的复数连用表示一些这两个句子我们已经很熟悉了因为这是我们在上一课当中学到的主要句型本课当中呢我们主要练习的是 there are 这个后面加上可数名词复数的结构再看两个例句There are some armchairs in the room. 房间里面有一些扶手椅。The armchairs are near the table. 扶手椅在桌子的旁边。There are some pictures in the room. 房间里面有一些照片。The pictures are on the wall. 照片在墙上。在看完了课文中的主要语言点之后，我们来总结一下本课中出现的基本句型。在上一个教学单元中，我们的基本句型是 There is a 在什么地方有一个什么东西，而本课的基本句型是 There are some 在什么地方有一些什么东西，后面接的是可数名词的复数。 There are some on, in, near. 在什么的上面、里面、旁边有一些什么东西。好，来看一组例句。There are some books on the shelf. 架子上有一些书。The books are new. 这些书是新的。同样呢，还请大家来注意一下这个定冠词的使用。好，下面我们来扩展一下，看看怎样表达在什么地方没有一些什么东西，怎么样来询问在什么地方有一些什么东西吗？也就是说，来看看这个句型的否定句和疑问句。There aren't any books on the shelf. 架子上没有书。请注意，在肯定句当中我们用的是 some books, 一些书，而在否定句当中用的是 any books。Are there any books on the shelf? 架子上有一些书吗？在疑问句当中，同样的 some 要变成 any。好，下面我们再来看一遍课文，请大家跟读，并且注意 there are 这个句型的使用。
Mrs. Smith's living room is large. There is a television in the room. The television is near the window. There are some magazines on the television.There is a table in the room. There are some newspapers on the table. There are some armchairs in the room. The armchairs are near the table. There is a stereo in the room. The stereo is near the door.There are some books on the stereo. There are some pictures in the room. The pictures are on the wall.
好，让我们进入下一课的学习，来做一些 there are some 的替换练习。Lesson 28, Where are they? Plates on the cooker.Clean， 我们要用这三个关键词或者是词组来做成两个句子。在第一个句子当中呢，说明在什么的上面有什么东西；在第二个句子里面来描述一下这件东西。There are some plates on the cooker. They are clean. Trousers on the bed. Near that shirt.There are some trousers on the bed. They are near that shirt. Bottles in the refrigerator. Empty. There are some bottles in the refrigerator. They are empty. Shoes on the floor.Near the bed. There are some shoes on the floor. They are near the bed. 好，在这张图片当中呢，我们看了一些 forks 叉子，还有一些 spoons 勺子 on the shelf. Near those spoons. 我们来问一下，桌子上是不是有一些刀子？Are there any knives on the shelf? No, there aren't any. There are some forks. Where are they exactly? Exactly, 确切的。确切的说，他们在哪儿？ They are near those spoons. Tickets on the shelf in that handbag.Are there any pens on the shelf? No, there aren't any. There are some tickets. Where are they exactly? They are in that handbag. Glasses. On the television. Near those bottles. Are there any cups on the television? No, there aren't any. There are some glasses. Where are they exactly? They are near those bottles. 今天我们学习的句型是 There are some 后面加上可数名词的复数来表示人或者物的存在。同时呢，还是请大家来注意定冠词的使用。如果是第二次出现特指，那么我们就要用定冠词 the。好，请大家在课后注意做一下复述。复述的时候呢，请注意您的顺序。而且在学习了 there is、there are 之后，我们可以用我们所学的知识来描述一下你的房间、你的办公室或者你的教室。好，今天的课就到这儿了。Thank you and goodbye.